Welcome back to my channel. My name is Ray, otherwise known as Disney Circus Girl, and these are my top 10 rides at Disneyland Paris. Okay, so the first ride on this list, in at number 10, is Ratatouille. I don't actually have any footage of the ride, so here are some quick shots of the gift shop. This has only managed number 10. It reached a lot higher on other people's lists, but for me it's only managed number 10. That's because, quite frankly, the smells of the kitchen make me feel a bit sick when I'm on the ride. As a ride, it is very good though, and I cannot wait for you guys in Orlando to experience it at Walt Disney World in Epcot. Okay, so in at number 9 is Peter Pan's Flight over in Fantasyland. Now, I know for a lot of you, this ride will be right up there. However, with me, it's only at the number 9 spot. And this is mainly, well, actually, no, not mainly, but this is a big part is of this is the queue. The queue is mostly outside, and it's been known to rack up queues of up to 2 to 3 hours sometimes. And I can't queue that long for what the ride actually is. It is what it is. It's a lovely little ride, but I would not queue any more than 15 minutes for this, I'm afraid. I just have much more things to do in Disneyland Paris, and yes, this ride is timeless, but once you've done it, you've done it. You don't need to do it again, and I would just leave it at that. Okay, so my number 8 ride is actually, surprisingly for me, It's a Small World. I'm not overly a fan of It's a Small World as a whole. Jay definitely is no longer a fan of it. However, it does hold some very special memories to me, and I do absolutely love this room that we're just heading into now, the White Room. I think this is the most gorgeous room on a theme park ride ever. Okay, so at number 7 on this list is Casey Jr. over in Fantasyland. This is a great little ride. I genuinely love this ride. This is one of the most fun rides I have ever been on. It's a lot faster than you would think. Jay loves it every time we go as well. It's honestly so much fun, and if you get there early enough, you can just keep going around and around and around, and it's honestly so much fun. And who doesn't love Casey Jr.? At number six on my list is Buzz Lightyear Laser Blast. Now, this ride is kind of bittersweet because this ride actually replaced Le Visionarium, which was the original timekeeper. Not many people know that Disneyland Paris had the original timekeeper, and that this was the building that it was housed in. And in this first scene, it's a little way back, there was a fire hydrant right at the start. Nine Eye is there. This ride has recently been completely revamped, refurbished, and I am really looking forward to seeing its refurb and seeing what it looks like now and seeing all the updates and everything. I think it's going to be amazing. I'm purposely not looking at videos online until I can get back to the parks myself. So yeah, this is a great ride. This was Jay's first ever ride at a Disney park, and it became a tradition then. Every time we went, the first stop was the Buzz ride. So yes, number six is Buzz Lightyear Laser Blast.
Attention, Space Rangers, you've landed on Planet Z. Be ready for anything.
I don't feel much of this now.
Okay, so we're over to the Walt Disney Studios park for the next ride, and this is a ride that I have no footage for. It's the Tower of Terror. I have no footage because, not because I just don't, but because it has a strictly no filming policy, so these few photos will have to do. This is an absolute classic ride. The Disneyland Paris version has several different drops. It has several different characters. You get a different character, different experience with each ride. So yeah, well worth going on this ride. Okay, so in at number four, it's an absolute classic, Pirates of the Caribbean. Now the French version is a little bit different to the versions in America, not least because most of it's in French. But also, the characters are different. We still have elements of it in its original form, and we also have a different redhead. Our redhead is actually, well, Pirate Red, sorry, we don't have Pirate Red. Our Pirate Red is much closer to the original redhead, and she doesn't talk, but her eyes are very, very realistic, and the way she moves is very, very realistic. In fact, I think I actually prefer her to Pirate Red over in America. Also, we have this amazing Captain Barbossa animatronic, and it's a brilliant little ride. And what's more, also you've got to go past the Captain Jack's restaurant as well at the start of the ride. And all of this, the whole experience of this ride is just simply amazing, and it's one that I do every single time that I am at Disneyland Paris. It is one of my favourite rides of all time. It's a very tough one to beat. Okay, so at number three on my list, Jay is going to be so happy about this because this is Jay's favourite ride of all time. It's Big Thunder Mountain. Big Thunder Mountain in Disneyland Paris is on an island on its own. It's a lot bigger scale than the one in Orlando, and it's a whole lot more fun. The only thing that does let this one down compared to Orlando is the wildest ride in the wilderness. It's just not, it's not there. Yes, they do say it, but they just go, it's the wildest ride in the wilderness, which is nowhere near as exciting. But yes, this is Jay's favourite ride of all time. And it's a classic, so I'm really not surprised. And it's, like I said, it's number three on my list. Let's just watch this footage and enjoy it together. Okay, so at number two on my list, the big number two, it's Star Wars Hyperspace Mountain. This ride is absolutely amazing. This is my favourite ride, like my favourite roller coaster of all time. A lot of people have said that Mission 2 was better, but I much prefer Star Wars Hyperspace Mountain. It is an amazing ride. Only bad point about this is that there's not a lot of leg room, so if you're tall, your legs are going to get a bit crushed. The harnesses are extremely snug on this ride. They are padded, but they are extremely snug. It's a very smooth roller coaster, and like, just, yeah, there's none of that back-breaking stuff that goes on in Orlando. And yes, this one does have inversions. And finally, at number one, I don't think it's going to surprise anyone here that Phantom Manor is my favourite ride, not just at Disneyland Paris, but of all time in any theme park. Phantom Manor is my favourite. The storyline is so strong, not just on the ride, but the storyline of Phantom Manor is actually the storyline of the entire of Frontierland. I have done so many videos of this ride and of the story of Thunder Mesa and Melanie Ravenswood, and oh, I cannot sing its praises enough, and this is the ride that I really, really, really cannot wait to get back on. And this is the ride that no matter, even if I'm only at Disneyland Paris for 2 or 3 hours, this is the one I go on every single time. So I'm not going to show the entire ride here. I'm just going to show a few highlights and show plenty of Melanie. And I just, please, please, please join me when I next go to Disneyland Paris. I'm thinking of live streaming this. I hope that you love this ride as much as I do. So thank you for watching, and until next time, let's just enjoy this footage and I'll see you soon. Veuillez faire attention à la marche.